Hey you guys, Harrison here, and you guys seem to like autoclickers quite a bit. So if you liked all of those autoclickers, then you're going to love this one, because I've found an autoclicker for Android that does not require any root access. It works really, really well. I've played around with it this morning. So let's check it out and I'll show you how to set it up for yourself. All right, so the first thing we're gonna do is grab our phone and we're gonna go to the Google Play Store and download and install the FREP app. So while the FREP app is downloading on your phone, you're gonna have to jump onto a computer and visit the link in the video description to download the matching FREP server app for whatever operating system your computer is running. So back on our phone, we're gonna have to dive into a few of the developer options. So the developer options are hidden by default, but we can make them visible by opening up the settings app and going to System, About Phone, and where it says Build Number, if we tap on that a few times, it'll say Developer Options Enabled, something like that. Now if we go back, we can open up the developer options. So just scroll down to where it says USB debugging, and we're gonna turn that on and press OK. And then also, just to make it a bit easier, we're gonna scroll down, and where it says Show Touches, turn that on as well. Now open up the FREP app, and now we're gonna need to connect our phone into our computer. So now that you've connected the two, a message should appear on your phone that says Allow USB Debugging. So just tick the box that says Always Allow This Computer, and then press OK. So now back on our computer, we need to open up the FREP folder that we extracted earlier, and inside on Windows, there'll be a file called win.bat, and on Mac, there'll be a file called mac.sh. So now if you open up that file, a terminal or a command prompt window will open up, and after a few lines of text, it should have a line that says server started and installation finished. If you get some sort of error, then you might want to try using the win.alt or the mac.alt file instead. Once the server has started though, back on our phone, what we can do inside the FREP app up the top, we can press the start stop service button. And now if it's connected correctly, it should come up with some new buttons and it'll say that the FREP service is running. Now we can actually disconnect our phone from our computer, and there's just two things that we've got to do before we can start auto-clicking. So the first thing we're gonna do is calibrate FREP. So that'll just make it work a bit better and help it tap a bit quicker. So to do that, we're just gonna press the three menu dots in the top right and then press on calibrate input, then just follow along the prompts until it says start test, then just let FREP do its thing and then press tap to save at the very end. Now we've also just got to enable the FREP accessibility service. So open up the settings app and go to accessibility and then tap on FREP and then just turn it on. All right, now we're good to go. So open up the app that you want to auto click in and then scroll down from the notifications and there should be a big notification from FREP and just tap on it where it says show console. And then a new little overlay will come up on our screen. Now what we're gonna do is press that red button in the FREP window that's on top of our app, and FREP's gonna start recording our inputs now. So we wanna tap as quick as we can, exactly where we want FREP to be tapping. And once you've tapped enough, lock your device by pressing the power button. Now, if you unlock your phone again, you'll see a new FREP window has popped up. So FREP's actually gonna save that action that we just recorded so we can keep repeatedly playing it back. So just give it a short name, something like tap or clicker or something. And then where it says repeat, change it from 1 to something like 50 or 100 times. And then just press the save button to save the action. Now, once you press save, you'll see that in the top left, instead of saying record, FREP will now have the name that we gave our macro as well as a play button. And now if you press that play button, FREP will start auto-clicking exactly where you were clicking before, and it'll keep repeating up to the number of repetitions that we typed in. Now if you want to stop your macro before it's finished running, all you've got to do is tap on the screen and FREP will pause where it is. And if you decide that you want to make your macro run for even longer, say so you can run it overnight, all you've got to do is open up FREP and press on where it says Manage Traces, and then tap on the macro that we created, and then where it says Replay/Repeat Settings, press that, and change repetition or repeat to something like 8,000 or 9,000. And then that means that the macro will run for almost forever, pretty much, and then you can just tap on it when you want it to stop. And now to fully shut down the FREP app, what you've got to do is open the app up and then press the menu dots in the top right and press shut down STR server. What this means though is to start using FREP again, you'll have to first reconnect your phone to your computer and run the little FREP program on your computer to get the server started again. So that's all there really is to it though. This app doesn't even need root access, just needs to connect to your computer for a few seconds. So hopefully you'll enjoy it, enjoy auto-clicking on whatever you want. And hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe down below. And also, it'd be really good if you could follow me on social media, on Twitter and on Instagram. Apart from that though, thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next video.